Huh. Well then, New England Patriots owner Robert Kraft is facing charges in Jupiter, Florida for his involvement in a prostitution ring. Police reportedly unleashed a sting operation and have charged 25 men for their involvement, including Kraft. Police would only give a few details on the matter, saying they found evidence on surveillance video. They said Kraft was caught soliciting prostitutes about a month before the charges were announced. This is crazy. This is yet another scandal that hovers over the Patriots' 21st century dynasty. One that has produced 9 Super Bowl appearances and 6 Lombardi trophies. But surely this embarrassing scandal involving the owner is bound to put a huge dent in arguably the greatest dynasty ever. What does this mean for Kraft, Bill Belichick, Tom Brady, and the entire Patriots organization? A lot. And none of it is good. I'm Jason Biondo, and today we present why Robert Kraft's prostitution sting will completely destroy the Patriots dynasty. Don't forget to subscribe to TPS and put on your notifications. We post videos every single day. Every day is a new video, so you have to subscribe. It's a really good idea. Go do it. Join the notification squad. It's a dope squad. Spygate and Deflategate were obviously embarrassing scandals to the New England Patriots organization. But Robert Kraft's involvement in a human trafficking prostitution sting will undoubtedly kill the integrity of this franchise. On February 2nd, 2019, it was reported by the Jupiter Police Department in Florida that the Patriots owner was being charged with 2 counts soliciting prostitution. Kraft's spokesperson denied the allegations in a statement, but come on. They always do that. Police set up cameras and were able to catch the illegal acts on surveillance tapes. So it's gonna be very hard for Kraft to weasel his way out of this one. So guys, this is how the Patriots dynasty is finally gonna end. Tom Brady and Bill Belichick led this group to its 6th Super Bowl championship in 17 years. That was less than a month ago. If you didn't watch, they defeated the Los Angeles Rams 13-3 in a very boring game. Some thought that old age would eventually slow down the Patriots. But Brady might play until he's 75, whereas Belichick will coach as long as he wants. The 6th Super Bowl was likely going to be New England's last in the Brady era, but there was always hope they'd add a 7th, and perhaps even an 8th. Well, you could throw that dream out the window. And now, finally, our division has a chance. Let's go, J-E-T-S, Jets, Jets, Jets. Jupiter Police Chief Daniel Kerr said, "Yes, aren't we all stunned?" I'm not really that stunned, to be honest. Every single owner of a football organization has probably done this. Just ask Jerry Jones. He's also done something like this before. They're all doing it. Kraft bought the long-struggling Patriots franchise in 1994 and saved the franchise from nearly relocating to Connecticut, even though some put an asterisk on the Patriots dynasty with the 2 cheating scandals. I think most Patriots haters at least admitted they had marvelous respect for Kraft. He was viewed as a humble owner who cared greatly for his family, friends, and fans. Kraft has been viewed as one of the most generous philanthropists in New England. He even gave funds to the Massachusetts General Hospital in order to fight the opioid crisis. But everything Kraft has worked for as an owner of the Patriots? Well, some might say it's tarnished now. He's the man that bought the Patriots and built their path to a dynasty. And now that path is crumbling before our very eyes. ESPN and Pro Football Talk were quick to point out the personal conduct policy, which Kraft and all owners are subject to follow. It is a privilege to be part of the National Football League, the first paragraph of the policy reads. Everyone who is part of the league must refrain from conduct detrimental to the integrity of and public confidence in the NFL. This includes owners, coaches, players, other team employees, game officials, and employees of the league office, NFL Films, NFL Network, or any other NFL business. Wow, that literally like covers everything. Like anything NFL, they can't do that. Go Kraft. Kraft may hire the best lawyers to help him avoid jail time, but he's not going to escape justice from Roger Goodell. Don't forget that Indianapolis Colts owner Jim Irsay received a 6-game suspension and $500,000 fine in 2014 for drunk driving. Kraft's case is a tad bit more serious here. Former Carolina Panthers owner Jerry Richardson was essentially forced to sell the team for allegedly making sexual and racial comments to employees while in the workplace. After 23 years of ownership, Richardson sold the team to David Tepper. Now yes, this is the Patriots organization, one of the best organizations ever known to the NFL, probably the best, to be honest. There's a very high chance that Kraft decides to or is simply asked by the NFL to sell the team. And if he does that, the following domino effect will come into play, and the Patriots dynasty is going to end, and the Jets can finally make a move and win a Super Bowl, or the Bills, or the Dolphins. I don't care. Someone in the division, other than the Patriots, please just win a playoff game. Please. Like, come on. This needs to happen. I'm sorry, I'm venting, but like, ah. Or Kraft might simply just step down and even just hand ownership over to his son, Jonathan Kraft. Also, take a look at the embarrassing scandal involving racial comments from former Los Angeles Clippers owner Donald Sterling. NBA Commissioner Adam Silver instructed him to sell the team, which Sterling did. It's not a zero-tolerance policy in the NFL. But Commissioner Roger Goodell will not let Kraft get away with this. He fined the Patriots and stripped away draft picks in the aforementioned Spygate and Deflategate scandals. Tom Brady was given a 4-game suspension for allegedly being involved in the deflating of footballs. Again, that was an alleged crime, and it's far less severe than what Kraft is being charged with. Best case scenario for Kraft? Probably a multi-game suspension and one hefty fine, one that will be at least $500,000. But whether it's only a suspension and fine, or Kraft being instructed to relinquish ownership, it's an awful look for this prideful Patriots organization. It's hard to see how they're going to recover from this. I can't think of another time where a sports dynasty had 3 major scandals like this and survived them all. So how will the Patriots do it? Well, for one, they're the Patriots, so, you know. Dynasties end, though. It happens. Caesar didn't last forever. His empire fell eventually. It happens. Even to the best. In one way or another. It was reported by ESPN's Seth Wickersham in January 2018 that Kraft and Belichick were at odds. The latter apparently wanted to move on from Tom Brady and roll with Jimmy Garoppolo. Kraft stepped in and forced Belichick to keep Brady and trade Jimmy G, which made Emperor Palpatine a very unhappy Sith Lord. Well, this serious offense committed by Kraft won't do much to help his relationship with Belichick. The latter has taken great pride in giving the Patriots a clean reputation, helping them work through the Spygate and Deflategate scandals. How embarrassing is it now that his boss was soliciting sex? Hard to see Belichick having much more respect for his boss. And don't forget the rumors that he was interested in returning to the New York Giants as the head coach. Might Belichick decide his work in Foxborough is done after this latest scandal? Or he just knew about it the whole time, who knows? Him and Kraft, not too cool with each other, I don't know, just an idea, not trying to start rumors. Not trying to gossip, but you know, trying to gossip, who knows? All of that work Belichick did to restore integrity in the organization, and his boss goes out and does something like this. Even if Kraft stays on as owner, you can sure as heck believe that this relationship with Belichick, it's gonna be strained way more. There's probably no fixing it at this point. So what does this do for the Patriots franchise? Well, sorry Patriots fans, but it just adds more taint to the dynasty. I mean, as far as Patriots haters are concerned. Belichick orchestrated Spygate. Brady orchestrated Deflategate, allegedly. Kraft has been charged with soliciting prostitution. That's a 1-2-3 punch. The 3 most prominent figures in the history of this model organization all have an asterisk next to their names. Call it a witch hunt all you want, call me a hater. But Patriots fans, the 70s Steelers, 80s 49ers, and 90s Cowboys, they don't have any asterisks on their dynasties. You throw in the Tuck rule and the awful officiating that benefits the Patriots on an annual basis, and a lot of other things that they got lucky on, and it's just not a good look on the franchise. They could have easily avoided all these controversies. Like it or not, there will always be multiple asterisks on this team's accomplishments. And I know that hurts, but you should probably just accept it and wear it like armor, and they can never use it to hurt you. Tyrion Lannister, Game of Thrones, Season 1, Episode 1. Great show. The aforementioned report from Wickersham also outlined that Brady and Belichick were at a tense point in their relationship. Brady was unhappy about not being named Patriot of the Week, and he was scolded for making some bad throws in a 2016 playoff game against the Houston Texans. Well, him and Belichick have been able to brush whatever tension there is aside. Kraft was the guy that held the glue together. But now what? We don't know what's going on behind the scenes. But if Brady and Belichick really refuse to talk to each other much these days, how is the relationship going to get fixed? Belichick knew he had to respect his boss, and Brady has obviously developed a very strong friendship with Kraft. Like very strong. Like too strong. Like kissing each other on the lips at the end of the Super Bowl strong. Yeah. It's kind of weird. Now that the latter has become a disgrace, it's impossible to see a scenario where Kraft can effectively patch things up between his quarterback and head coach. And as we all know by now, power struggles between influential figures in professional sports almost never ends well. That's how the Jim Harbaugh-led San Francisco 49ers broke up. The 90s Cowboys could have won more Super Bowls if Jerry Jones didn't foolishly kick head coach Jimmy Johnson out the door. Alright, so now this never-happy Belichick has to find a way to get along with his 42-year-old quarterback with Kraft possibly being completely out of the picture for an extended period of time? Whoa, that's a lot. Perhaps almost 20 years together, Brady might finally snap at Belichick, and the relationship will reach a breaking point. So, Now you have a disgraced owner, a quarterback entering his age 42 season, and the fact that the Patriots have to deal with Patrick Mahomes, a healthy Andrew Luck, and Deshaun Watson in the AFC. Boy, that's fun. All good things must come to an end, but the Patriots dynasty and dominant run will be ending sooner than we thought. Think about how close Kansas City was to ending New England's season in the 2018 AFC Championship game. Well, the Chiefs should be even better in Mahomes' second full season as a starter. Don't fool yourself. 42-year-old Brady is not going to be better than 24-year-old Mahomes. He better give those refs a couple extra sketchy high fives. You also can't help but wonder if this will influence Rob Gronkowski's decision to step away from football. The Pro Bowl tight end has pondered retirement over the past year now. Does he really want to keep it going? Or is it time to step away as the Patriots dynasty starts its downward spiral? Gronk, if you can hear me, listen. The WWE and Hollywood are waiting for you. You are meant to be a star, Gronk. Your name was meant to be seen in lights, and not just with the Patriots. Just imagine the Hollywood Walk of Fame right in front of the Dolby Theater. Gronk. All right, so perhaps this will affect the Patriots in free agency as well. Other teams might be weary of joining a team amid this huge scandal. Might Trey Flowers, the team's best pass rusher, decide he better leave as well? Most of the greatest dynasties in North America sports never really fell apart because of controversy. The 90s Chicago Bulls broke up when Michael Jordan retired, and the other stars left for new teams. The 90s Cowboys got too old. Salary cap constraints will break up the Golden State Warriors. Those are all natural and more graceful ways of a dynasty to end. But like, my God, the Patriots fell apart because their owner did something like this? That's crazy. Honestly, I never thought a sports dynasty will have a sour ending like this, but the 21st century is crazy. Yeah. And so, this is what happens 3 weeks after the Patriots added their 6th Lombardi trophy to their resume. It wasn't a thriller, but it was a cherry on top of their tremendous run. 6 Super Bowl titles, but 3 asterisks next to them. So that's kind of like 3, maybe 3.5. You know, I'm just a Jets fan, I'm sorry. Robert Kraft was the man who bought the Patriots and built them into the greatest sports team of the 21st century. And he's also going to be responsible for being the man that kickstarted Operation Demise in Foxborough. Do you think Robert Kraft's prostitution scandal will destroy the Patriots dynasty? Join us in the comment section below. Make sure to follow myself and Total Pro Sports on social media. We post great content all the time. Great content, at least go check out our profiles. Give it a look. Be like, oh, Instagram, what's up? Oh my God, Twitter, I like you guys. I'm gonna follow. That's all you gotta do. Just follow. Takes one click. Give it a look. See what you think. If you like this video, give it a like. Takes one click as well. Right down there. Right there. Clickety click click. That's all you gotta do. We really appreciate it. Either way, we appreciate you. You're great. If this is your first time around TPS, make sure to, that's right, subscribe, because we post videos every single day. Every day is a new video, so you should definitely subscribe. Of course, thank you so much for watching. I'm Jason Biondo, and I'll see you next time.
On my knees.